Hello everyone. In this video, I'm going to talk about amino acids, building blocks of proteins. They are literally the alphabet of protein structure and determine many of the important properties of proteins. How many of you have a problem remembering the structure of amino acids and their characteristics? Well, when I started learning about amino acids, I struggled a lot memorizing the structure of amino acids and their characteristics, but I discovered an easy way. In this video, I am going to make it very easy for you to remember the structure and properties of standard amino acids. Before we go into the details, let's talk a little about the history of amino acids. Did you know that the first amino acid discovered was asparagine? It was isolated from asparagus in 1806. And the most recently discovered amino acid is threonine. It was identified in 1935. It is quite interesting that it took almost more than 100 years to discover 20 standard amino acids. Let's talk about the standard amino acids. What are the standard amino acids? 20 alpha amino acids, commonly found in proteins, also called as standard amino acids. All amino acids, except proline, have a common denominator, as you can see here, a free carboxyl group and a free unsubstituted amino group on the alpha carbon atom. They differ from each other in structure of their distinctive side chains, which is called as the R group. As I mentioned, proline is an exception, which has R group substituted in the amino group, as you can see here. There are four main classes of amino acids: amino acids with nonpolar or hydrophobic R groups, amino acids with neutral or uncharged R groups, amino acids with positively charged R groups, and amino acids with negatively charged R groups. This is the easiest way to remember the classification of amino acids. Let's see more in detail which amino acids belong to these categories and why. Amino acids with nonpolar or hydrophobic R groups, as a group, these amino acids are less soluble in water than the amino acids with polar R groups, as the name suggests, hydrophobic, right? This family includes 5 amino acids with aliphatic hydrocarbon R groups, which are alanine, valine, leucine, isoleucine, and proline. To remember these amino acids, I have come up with the phrase, all is well, Lisa is pro. There are 2 amino acids with aromatic rings, which are phenylalanine and tryptophan, and 1 containing sulfur, which is methionine. I have come up with the phrase fitrimet. So if you remember the phrase, all is well, Lisa is pro, fitrimet, you can immediately think that these amino acids belong to the category of amino acids with nonpolar or hydrophobic R groups. Out of these 8 amino acids, alanine is the least hydrophobic, and hence it is the borderline between nonpolar amino acids and those with uncharged polar R groups. As you see here, in alanine, the R group is only methyl group, and it is in borderline in the properties of this category. If you remember the structure of alanine, it becomes very easy for you to remember the structure of the rest of the amino acids in that phrase. Let's see the structure of valine. Valine has 2 methyl group connected with a CH2 group. Leucine, again, a similar structure, but it is extended with an additional CH2 group. Isoleucine, again, the position of methyl group is changed, but it has same number of carbon atoms. And proline, as I mentioned before, the R group is shared by amino group. So it is very easy for you to remember the structure of proline if you remember this. Phenylalanine, now we know the structure of alanine. So if the phenyl ring is attached to alanine, it becomes phenylalanine. Again, it's very easy to remember. Tryptophan, in this structure, I think to remember the structure of tryptophan, you have to put some extra efforts. There are 2 to 3 amino acids from total 20 amino acids, where you have to put some efforts to remember. So this is one of the amino acids. Methionine, as we know, it has sulfur, so CH2CH2SCH3. So again, it is very easy to remember. If you remember the phrase "all is well, Lisa is pro, Fitrimet," and the group presents the characteristics of the R groups, and it becomes easy for you to remember all amino acids. Another class is amino acids with neutral or uncharged polar R groups. As a group, these amino acids are more soluble in water than those with non-polar R groups. Their R group contain neutral or uncharged polar functional groups which can hydrogen bond with water. This is the main characteristic of amino acids with polar R groups. For this class, I have come up with the phrase glycer, thro, tire as glucy. Gly, glycine. Ser, serine. Thro, threonine. Tire, tyrosine as aspargine. Glu, glutamine. C, cysteine. In this category, glycine is a borderline member. As you see here, the R group is a single hydrogen atom, which is too small to influence the high degree of polarity of the alpha amino and alpha carboxyl group. So glycine comes as a borderline member for this category. The polarity of serine, threonine, and tyrosine is contributed by their hydroxyl groups. The polarity of aspargine and glutamine is contributed by amide group, and polarity of cysteine is contributed by sulfhydryl group. So if you look at the structure of serine, now we know that serine has hydroxyl group, so it's very easy to remember the R group is CH2OH in serine. Threonine, similarly, it has hydroxyl group, so CHOH-CH3 as R group. Tyrosine, we know the structure of phenylalanine, right? So if we attach hydroxyl group at the phenyl ring, the structure becomes tyrosine. Again, it is very easy to remember. Aspargine, we know that in aspargine, the polarity is contributed by CONH2. So the structure is CH2CONH2. Again, easy to remember. Glutamine, one more CH2. So it is CH2CH2CONH2. So again, it becomes very easy to remember the structure of aspargine and glutamine. If you remember, it has a CONH2 group. Similarly, cysteine, we know that cysteine has sulfhydryl group. So the structure is very easy, CH2SH. So if you remember the phrase which I created, glycer, thro, tire as glucy, and the different groups which contribute polarity to these amino acids, it is very easy for you to remember the structure of this group amino acids. Another category is amino acids with positively charged R groups. We can also call them the basic amino acids. These amino acids have R groups which has a positive charge at pH 7, and all amino acids have 6 carbon atoms. To remember this class of amino acids, I have come up with the phrase lethargy. So you can also remember this way, lysine, arginine, and histidine. If you remember lethargy, you have to make some effort to remember lethargy word with the lysine, arginine, and histidine. As you see here, the lysine consists of positively charged amino group at the sigma position on its aliphatic chain. So CH2CH2CH2CH2NH3. It is aliphatic and it has amino group positively charged. So that's how you remember lysine, and that gives makes it a basic amino acid, and it gives the positive charge to lysine. The second is arginine. As I mentioned, arginine bears the positively charged guanidium group. Guanidium group, 3 amino group, as you see here at the end. CH2, CH2, CH2 and guanidinium group. So it gives the positive charge to amino acid arginine. And the third one is histidine. Histidine has a imidazolium group. As you see, histidine, again, the structure of histidine is quite quite not that easy. You have to make some efforts to remember. If you remember the ring structure of imidazolium ring, then it becomes very easy. CH2 is connected with the imidazolium group. In this category, the histidine is the borderline amino acid in its properties, because at pH 6, somewhat over 50% of histidine molecules possess a proton positively charged R groups, but at pH 7, less than 10% have a positive charge. So histidine comes into the borderline category in this family. So again, it's very easy to remember. Lethargy, lysine, arginine and histidine. And histidine is at the borderline. And again, this is the another amino acids where you need some efforts to remember the structure. Fourth group, which is amino acids with negatively charged R groups. We can also call them acidic amino acids. There are two amino acids. This is again very easy, aspartic acid and glutamic acid. I have not made any phrase because it is very easy to remember. There are only two acids, aspartic acids and glutamic acid. And both have second carboxyl group, which is fully ionized, and hence it gives the negative charge at pH 6 to 7. The structure, aspartic acid, as I mentioned, it has carboxyl group, so CH2COO, and glutamic acid, CH2CH2 and COO. So again, it's very easy to remember the structure of aspartic acid and glutamic acid. In addition to the standard amino acids, several others of relatively rare occurrence amino acids have been isolated from hydrolysates of some specialized type of proteins. All are derivatives of some standard amino acids. For example, 4-hydroxyproline, which is found in fibrous protein collagen, hydroxylysine, which is found in some plant proteins, desmosine and isodesmosine found in fibrous protein elastin, sigma and methyllysine, trimethylysine and methylhistidine, they are found in certain muscle proteins. There are many more amino acids, but I have not listed all because it's not possible. But yeah, these are the few amino acids which are very rare, but they are they exist in the nature. In addition to the 20 common, which are standard amino acids, and several rare amino acids of proteins, over 150 other amino acids are known to occur biologically in free or combined form, but never in proteins. Some non-protein amino acids are important precursors or intermediate in metabolism, such as beta-alanine, which is a building block of vitamin pentathionic acid, homocysteine and homoserine, they are intermediates in amino acid metabolism. Citrulline and ornithine, they are intermediates in the synthesis of arginine. Gamma-aminobutyric acid, which is involved in transmission of nerve impulses. Deconfigured amino acids such as D-glutamic acid, found in the cell walls of many bacteria. D-alanine, found in the larvae or pupae of some insects. And D-serine, found in earthworms. Fungi and higher plants contain an extraordinary variety of non-protein amino acids such as cannavenin, beta-cyanoalanine, and this could be also the toxic to certain forms of life. There are other non-protein amino acids which I have not mentioned, but just to give you an idea that in addition to 20 standard amino acids, there are other amino acids also exist in the nature. Hope this video helped you to understand and remember the protein structure and their properties easily. If you have any question or suggestion, feel free to leave a comment. and stay tuned for more videos on fundamentals of proteomics. I will discuss different proteomic approaches and the basic chemistry behind it. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for my next video. Thank you.